Good morning, everybody, and happy Thursday. Today is Thursday, January 28th, and here are the announcements for today. Please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
For a moment of silence. Thank you. You may be seated. Well, today we are wishing a very happy birthday to Sebastian Castro and Marcela Rodriguez. Happy birthday to you. And here's the news from Dr. Lopez's Nest.
Good morning, Wise Owls, and happy Thursday. Boys and girls, today I am very excited, and I am excited about different things. First of all, I'm very excited that tomorrow we will be having our literature in the park. Teachers, we're still looking for volunteers, so please, please, please take a moment and share your favorite book on video so that the boys and girls can get to know you and your favorite books a little bit better. Also, boys and girls, on tomorrow, remember we do have our PTA casual day that has to do with your favorite character. Now, the reason why I'm very, 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 very excited is that as you maybe notice, my screen today is a little bit different. You're not gonna see a percentage because I'm going to let you think about it and try to predict what our attendance rate was for yesterday. Now, look at all these classes that have 100% attendance. In pre-K, we had Ms. Contreras and Ms. Rivera. In kindergarten, we had Ms. Blanco, Ms. D. Garcia, Ms. Garcia Iniguez, and Mr. Rodriguez. We had full house in kindergarten. So great job, kindergarten. But that's not all. In first grade, we had Ms. Heaston, Ms. Lucky, Ms. Monroe, Ms. Rosello, and Ms. Cruz. We had full house in first grade. So that's two grade levels in a row. And then we get second grade with Ms. Gomez, Ms. Heaston, Ms. Monroe, Ms. Rubio, and Ms. Savin Baker, also full house in second grade. So we had kindergarten, first and second. We had all of our students in school yesterday. That was really amazing. Now in third grade, Ms. Tassie's class had 100% attendance. In grade four, Ms. Bonin's class had 100% attendance, as well as Ms. Patino and Ms. X Perez and Ms. Vidal. And in fifth grade, we had Mr. Cheney, Ms. Coolin, and Ms. P. Rodriguez. So boys and girls, our attendance rate for Wednesday was 98%. That was our goal. So you see what happens when you pursue excellence? You actually set your mind to a goal, and then you work towards it and you reach your goal. So what does that mean? That means that as a consequence for your 98% attendance, that means that on Monday, February 1st, we will have a no uniform day. That means that obviously you still need to dress appropriately for school. We don't have any jeans, we don't have any leggings, but you can wear anything you like that is appropriate for school, and it does not have to be your uniform. So that is our reward for 98% attendance on Wednesday. Now, we also have movement. Obviously, we had Ms. Blanco's class in kindergarten. They went from 10 days with 100% attendance to 20 days with 100% attendance. So all this wonderful news regarding attendance. I hope to see more classes that move from one nest to the next, because I think, in fact, Ms. Blanco's class is on her way to 30 very soon. So let's see when that happens. So congratulations to all the classes who are working so hard to be here and to learn every single day. Those are all my announcements for today. Have a thrilling Thursday.
Thank you, Dr. Lopez. We're so excited about that no uniform day on Monday. Woohoo! All right, well, I wanna say thank you to all of the parents who joined us for our PTA general meeting and our fifth grade committee meeting last night, and to our PTA and fifth grade committee. Remember that our parent workshops today is about challenging behaviors. It's presented in Spanish at 10 a.m. and 1 p.m. And we are also having our Title I parent advisory committee. I couldn't remember the PAC. Parent advisory committee meeting this morning at 9:30 a.m. The information has been posted on our social media, the links, and you can also find it on our website. Tomorrow is another cartoon character casual day. So a lot of kids brought a dollar yesterday for our storybook character day. You didn't need to pay a dollar for that, but tomorrow you do. Tomorrow is our PTA cartoon character casual day. Bring your dollar, go on OHES.memberhub.store to pay your dollar, or bring your dollar into the building and get your wristband. And hey, don't forget, we have two more nights of bedtime stories with me, Mrs. Montero, tonight at 7:30. You can find them on our Oliver Hoover Elementary Facebook page, and it's also in our Oliver Hoover Media Center Teams. Tomorrow is our virtual literature in the park, as Dr. Lopez mentioned, and I wanted just to say thanks to those teachers who have already recorded stories for our kids, Ms. Aguilar, Dr. Lopez, Ms. Vidal, Ms. Blanco, Ms. Rivera, Ms. Monroe, Ms. J. Perez, Ms. Patino, Ms. Rosnick, Ms. Rubio, and Ms. S. Perez. Thank you for already recording your stories. But teachers, as Dr. Lopez said, it is not too late. It's tomorrow, so you still have all day today and even into the evening to record yourself on our Flipgrid that we can share your amazing stories tomorrow. And a reminder for our MSO students that there is meal distribution today from 4 o'clock to 5:30 p.m. And if you know anybody who is 4 years old and they're looking for VPK, our VPK registration is now open. It will be open until February 25th. If you're interested, you can stop by the main office at the main campus to register. The registration times are 8:30 to 12:30. And 2 o'clock to 3:30. So tell your friends and family if they have little ones that are looking for VPK for next year. We are accepting registrations now. And here is our Celebrate Literacy Week fact of the day. These are 11 ways that a parent can help a child learn to read. Number one, let your child see you reading. Remember, parents, you are such an important role model for your kids. When they see you reading, they know it's something that they want to do too, and they think it's important. Number two, look for appropriate word and reading games online to play with your child. There's so many, just Google it. Ask your child to draw a picture or write about what happens in a story. Keep paper, notebooks, pencils, pens, markers, and crayons available in your house. When you're reading a magazine or a newsletter, ask your child to look on the page for pictures that start with a certain sound. Do you see a picture of something that starts with a P? Set aside a time and a place for reading, like a comfy chair with a reading light for bedtime stories. Visit your public library regularly. Public libraries are open for checkout, and you can also request books from our library here at Oliver Hoover through the Oliver Hoover Media Center Teams. There's a form you can fill out, or you can do it by putting a hold on a book through Destiny Online Catalog. Enjoy reading with your child. Laugh at silly pictures. Make goofy voices. Have fun. Ask your child questions about the story as you read together to check for comprehension. What's the story about? Why do you think they made that choice? Was it a good choice? Why did it happen? Make a game out of finding words that rhyme or start with the same sound. Great phonemic awareness activities. After you finish reading a story, look back at a page and ask your child to find common words. Can you find the word the, me, up, go, and sight words? Teach your child to recognize his or her own name. And most importantly, for every age, read out loud to your child. books, poems, nursery recipes, billboards, newspaper articles, ad signs, whatever words you see. And here is my Thursday thought for you today. No one is perfect. That's why pencils have erasers. Wishing you all a thrilling Thursday, and we'll see you again tomorrow.